Hey, who likes to eat apple desserts but hates having to deal with cutting up the apples? So I want to show you something simply easy with Amy. This is Pampered Chef's apple peeler core slicer. It was one of the first items I got, came in my starter kit 22 years ago, oh my gosh. And I fell in love with it because I love apple desserts. So I want to show you real quick. It has a stand, it has the unit. We pop an apple on here and it's got a way to peel it. It's got a way to core it, slice it, the whole works. So I'm just going to put one hand here, one hand here. I'm going to go ahead and crank away and voila. In what was that, like, I don't know, 10, 15 seconds? I have beautifully peeled apple. Isn't this fun? You can do it for potatoes too. You can actually make really fancy Thanksgiving potatoes, all kinds of fun stuff. But I have already started the process of making an apple crisp. So right here, I have Pampered Chef's little tiny 1-quart enameled cast iron. And I've already got 3 other apples in there. So this is just the very, very end. I am just taking a little paring knife, going around. Look how fast this is. Oh my gosh, can you believe this? By the way, these other apples, I actually cut these up yesterday and I froze them. Do you know you can freeze baking apples? And, well, actually any apple, but apples that you're going to use for baking. And you can go ahead, freeze them, and then you can thaw them, and they turn out great. So I grew up doing this. We would do bushels full, and we'd have apple pie whenever we wanted. So I'm just gonna spread these around a little bit, kind of separate them a little bit. Usually I'm throwing them into a bowl with sugar and cinnamon and all that stuff. The other ones I've already done that with. These I'm just trying to get done real quick, because, and I'm not worried about adding the brown sugar and cinnamon, or the white sugar and cinnamon, because, let me see here. Okay, so first I have a little bit of water, lemon juice, and vanilla. Then I'm just gonna pour over the top. It's only, I don't know, a couple tablespoons, because this is a really small bowl. And then I made up a bunch of streusel that I'm actually using for a couple of different recipes. So this is just butter, brown sugar, flour, cinnamon. I used it with my caramel latte. Oh, I made Pampered Chef's new caramel latte bread today. So good. Put the streusel on some of them, put chopped apples in some of the others. And actually, I'm going to take this, and you know what? You can put it in the oven, but I don't want to heat up the oven for such a small container. So I'm just going to go ahead and I'm going to put it in the air fryer. So I love how everything turns out in the cast iron. It is so good. This is enough for like 2 people. So this is 4 apples. So, you know, when my kids were home, I'd make a whole, you know, 9x9, or I'd make a 9x13. It would get devoured. Now it's just me and my hubby. And you know what? Apple desserts are really not his thing. I might be forced to eat this whole thing by myself. It will be rough. It'll be hard. I know you will all stand with me. But we're just gonna put, and I am so bad when it comes to brown sugar. I love brown sugar and any kind of streusel topping. So you can add oatmeal to this. Some people do that. Some people add nuts, pecans, whatever. I'm not really a fan of that when it comes to apple crisp, even though I love pecans. But this is actually just gonna go, look how cute that is. This is just gonna go right into the air fryer. And it'll probably take about 30 minutes to bake. I'll pop it out and I can eat it with ice cream. I can eat it plain, cold, hot, whatever I wanted to do. But this is how easy it is just to do up a ton of apples. If I'm doing apple pie, it takes me 6 apples to do an apple pie. So I usually pound through and do 6 apples, and then I do 6 more apples and I put them in a freezer bag, date it and label it, throw it in the freezer, and then I don't know, it's usually good for 3-4 months. Anytime in the next 3-4 months I'm interested in pie, I just pull it out. Because the other thing I do is when I make a crust, I make extra crust. Because if you freeze pie crust, especially if you're doing homemade, and I'm gluten-free, so I have to do homemade, I actually just throw it in the freezer, and then I can pull it out 24 hours later. It's thawed enough to use, and I just have everything all prepped and ready to go, and I make it. So anyway, if you have any questions about anything apple-related, whether it's our updated core, or whether it's our our wedger that we've actually had forever. This is actually my original wedger. It's about 20 years old. Still works as great as the day I got it. Stainless steel, no rust, all for it. So let me know if you have any questions. And as always, I am here to help you in the kitchen and make it simply easy with me. Thanks, everybody.